By 1925, the crowded slums of New York City were slowly giving way to reforms. So were the factories and sweatshops. Labor unions were gaining strength, and class warfare was turning bloody. Nowhere was this more true than in the garment industry.
You had in New York at this time war between the management and the unions, both sides being Jewish. And each side began to use these hoodlums in the wars. As a consequence, they'd hire themselves out to each side. And that's where he began to get the idea, look, if you could control management and labor, you've got it made.
Lepke and Garat could see the opportunity in this new line of work. So they joined a gang run by a powerful 5'2" Jewish mobster named Little Augie Orgen, who specialized in labor violence. Little Augie recognized that Lepke's calculating business sense and Garat's hulking brawn would be profitable additions to his gang. They were just two of Orgen's 150-man organization, which was rented out to violently shake up labor disputes. Little Augie wasn't particular about who he worked for, labor or management. He just had a price list with special bargains for repeat customers. If a client wanted an arm or a leg broken, it would cost $5. Murder would cost $25 and up, depending on the prominence of the individual. Little Augie's gang focused on the rag trade, which at the time employed about 1 million people.
The wonderful thing about the garment industry is that you infiltrate the unions, they pay you off. You infiltrate management, they pay you off through because they're afraid of you.
Lepke soon grew tired of taking orders from Orgen and knew he could run the show better on his own. So he calmly decided to murder his boss and enlisted Garat to help him.